Hello students, this video is a continuation of exercise 1.5. Next problem is, first problem, fifth subdivision, 2 pi. So we have to classify whether this is rational or irrational. So we already know pi is an irrational number. So any operations to the, multiplication to the irrational number will be irrational number. So we have to prove that. So pi equal to 3.1415. So 2 pi equal to 2 into 3.1415 equal to 6.2830. Okay. Then since a number 2.38 2830 is non-terminating, non-recurring, 2 pi is an irrational number. So this is how we have to prove and write it. Then second problem, simplify each of the following expressions. So first problem is 3 plus root 3 into 2 plus root 2. So simplify, what is meaning of simplify means we have to bring the expression with only sum of rational and irrational numbers. That's the meaning of simplify. So here the question is product of 3 plus root 3 and 2 plus root 2. So we have to simplify this. So first what we will do, we will multiply 3 into 2 plus root 2. Okay, so I have shown in red color, can you see? So those red colors I have brought to the multiplication like this. Okay, 3 into 2 plus root 2 plus root 3 into 2 plus root 2. Okay, so this is how we wrote means distributive law of multiplication over addition. Then still more multiplying. So 3 into 2. Okay, so how we got means 3 is there outside the bracket, which means we have to multiply. So 3 into 2 plus 3 into root 2. Then root 3 into 2 plus root 3 into root 2. Okay, so 3 into 2 is 6. Then 3 into root 2 is, as such only we have to write 3 root 2. Then root 3 into 2. So that is also, we can't multiply anymore. So 2 root 3. Okay, then next last one is root 3 into root 2. So both are in root. So we will take the root together in the identities I shown in the slide in the previous video. So root of AB, it can be written as root A into root B. So here it is root A into root B. We are taking together as root AB. So root AB will be root 6. So that's the final answer. Okay, then next subdivision 3, root 5 plus root 2 the whole square. Okay, can you see in which form it is? It is of the form a plus b the whole square. So in that way only we have to expand it. Okay, so after expanding we will have root 5 square. Okay, a square, you take it as a as root 5. So root 5 square plus 2 into root 5 into root 2, 2ab, okay, in that form, 2ab, in that form we are writing 2 into root 5 into root 2 plus root 2 square, okay, so root 2 square. So after this we will get root 5 square. So root and square will get cancelled and we will have the number alone. Okay, is it not? Root and square is there means, so it will get cancelled and we will have the real number alone. Okay, then here 2 also same way, root 2 square, so it will be 2 only. Then in the middle 2 into root 5 into root 2, so 2 into root 10. Okay, then after adding 5 and 2 we will get 7 plus root 7 plus 2 root 10. Okay, this is the final answer we will get after simplifying. Moving to the next problem. Recall pi is defined as the ratio of the circumference, say C, of a circle to its diameter, say D. Okay, that is pi equal to C by D. This seems to contradict the fact that pi is irrational. How will you resolve this contradiction? Okay, so we all learnt what is pi. Pi is a constant which is the ratio of circumference to diameter. Okay, we have studied like that. So so it is always of the ratio 22/7. Okay, so we have learnt that, but still we can't every time tell that C and D are exactly measured. It's just measuring, right? So every time we can't say that it is measured exactly. It's a approximate value, is it not? Even a coin can be measured. Similarly, a bigger circle or even the earth circumference and diameter can be written, but it cannot be said that it is accurate. It's only approximate. That's why we can't say it is rational. Okay, so this is how we have to explain. There is no contradiction. When we measure a value with a scale, we only obtain an approximate value. We never obtain an exact value. Therefore, we may not realize whether C or D is irrational. The value of pi is almost equal to 22/7 or 3.142857, and it keep on going there, decimal expansion. So we don't have a correct exact value. Okay, it's just approximate value. So it's an irrational number, and there is no contradiction between rational or irrational and all. So it's clear that it is an irrational number. So moving to the next problem. Represent root 9.3 on the number line. Okay, so this is actually answer. The picture I have shown here is the final answer, but for the understanding purpose I have shown here. Let us go to the steps how to find out. Okay, first step, draw a 9.3 units long line segment AB. Extend AB to C such that BC equal to 1 unit. Okay, let me show the picture. So A to B is 9.3. Okay, A to B, the length is 9.3. Then still more, B to C, we are extending the line for 1 unit. Okay, 9.3 unit for A to B and B to C 1 unit. Okay, so totally AC is 10.3 unit. Okay, so this is the first step. Then second step is, now AC equal to 10.3 unit, let the center of AC be O. So we have to measure the center of AC. So we have to take that point as O. Then third step, draw a semicircle of radius OC with center O. Now we have to take the center of AC. That point as center, we have to draw a semicircle of radius OC. Okay, that is the third step. Then fourth step, draw a BD perpendicular to AC at point B, intersecting the semicircle at D, then join OD. Okay, we have to draw a perpendicular to AC from B, okay, to the semicircle, and that point where it touches the semicircle is D. Okay, then join OO, that is the center of semicircle, to D. We have to join it. Okay, so OBD obtained is a right angled triangle. So here again I have shown the picture. So we are getting a right angle triangle, OBD. This is a right angle triangle because OD is perpendicular to AC. We only did the perpendicular, no? So that is perpendicular. So it is a right angle triangle. So we have to move to the next step. So OD equal to OC equal to 10.3 by 2. That is the radius of the semicircle. Is it not? That's the radius of the semicircle. So that is of the length 10.3 by 2. Okay. Half of 10.3. Okay. Then BC. BC also we only measured and marked. So it is 1 unit. Then OB equal to OC minus BC. Okay. How to obtain OB? We have to minus OC, BC from OC. Okay. So then we can obtain the value of OB. So how to do it? So 10.3 divided by 2 minus 1 equal to 8.3 by 2. Okay. That is the value of OC. Sorry, OB. By Pythagoras theorem, we get OD square. Okay. OD square. That is the hypotenuse. Square equal to BD square plus OB square. So we know OD. We know OD and OB also we know. We don't know BD only. Okay. So substitute those values. So we have 10.3 by 2 the whole square equal to BD square plus 8.3 by 2 the whole square. Okay. So BD square is equal to, we have to bring the 8.3 by 2 the whole square to this side of the equal to, so it will come in minus. So the answer we will get BD square is equal to 9.3, then BD equal to root 9.3. So this is how we are getting. Okay. Then after that, the length of BD is equal to root 9.3. So step 5, take BD as radius and B as center, draw an arc which touches the line segment. The point where it touches the line segment is at a distance of root 9.3 from O as shown in figure. So let me show the picture again. So here you will see. Okay. So root 9.3 is here. Okay. We are going to keep B as center and this as radius. We are going to draw one more arc which touches the line segment. So that where it touches, that point is a root 9.3 on the line. Okay. This is how we have to draw. And here what I explained for the right angle triangle is just for understanding purpose. If it is asked for exam, you can write the steps alone. From step 1 to step 5 alone, you can write these in between calculations. You can omit if it is asked. Okay. So this is for understanding purpose only, how we are getting the root 9.3. For that purpose I explained here. Okay. So one more problem is there. I will explain you in the next video. I will wind up this video. Thank you, children.